Enjoy the commercial break.
We didn't. You know what happens when we go to commercial breaks?
Nothing.
That's right. We just stand here, sit down, or whatever, waiting for you guys.
Fortunately, you guys don't have to wait at all for Sarah Meyer.
VJ, model, entrepreneur, but so much more. She sat down with us on today's threesome. It's threesome, and we're here with the great VJ, DJ, model, producer, writer. Anything else?
That's
very
beautiful.
Very beautiful.
Sarah Meyer. Huh? So yeah. So now the tables have turned.
I know. This is interesting. I like being in the guest seat.
We don't really know much about your connection to hip hop.
It's my undercover. It's my secret sort of life. No, to be completely honest with you, I think the reason why nobody knows about the hip hop side of me was because for so long I tried to keep it under wraps. I think for a good chunk of my life, I felt like it was. There's such a stigma that comes with hip-hop. I felt like it was affecting everything else, like my relationship with clients, my endorsements, you know, veering away from the mainstream sort of like, oh, she's on TV, oh, she endorses, you know, products and things like that. But then there's this other side where it's like, yes, you know, I hang out with kids that do rap battles and things like that, which I think generally mainstream Philippines doesn't understand yet. Mm-hmm. And so when they associated me with that, there's a huge disconnect and they weren't very settled with it. So I tried to keep it secret.
So when did your love for hip hop really start?
I don't know that there's an answer for that. I think anybody that comes from a musically inclined family is already sort of, your senses are fine-tuned to pick up on different genres. Mm-hmm. And I just happened to fall in love with this one. I don't know what it is that resonated. Mm-hmm.
Why do you think hip-hop has kept you intrigued throughout the years? So much so that, you know, I mean, you write about it and you want to share your love for it with other people.
Because the levels of it are so, I mean, it goes to depths that I am still trying to get a grasp of. You know, I really can't comprehend. You know, like I said, it's steeped in jazz and all these other genres. So once you really start digging and understanding it, it just keeps going deeper and deeper. Like, what artist did they sample for this beat? And, you know, where does that draw back to? But I think the hip hop that everybody else is familiar with is, again, the stereotype of, you know, this gang scene. Mm-hmm. It's either that or the hip hop that they hear on radio or at the clubs where it's like, oh, women, cash, cars, you know what I'm saying? Bling, like all of that. There's this huge middle area of, you know, not necessarily uber conscious hip hop, but just hip hop that makes sense, where it's very socially relevant and still fun to listen to. And the artistry, at the end of the day, rap is poetry.
How about the local scene? How do you find yourself immersed suddenly in, and how different is it from, let's say, New York?
The thing about comparing anything to hip hop in New York is you're taking headquarters, you know, you're taking like the motherland of all hip hop. This is the birthplace. The Philippines is still, we're still sort of finding our way. Like, it's an uphill climb.
How different are the hip-hop scenes in Manila? In Manila, at the least.
And people keep saying hip-hop is dead everywhere in the world. Even here in the Philippines, like, oh, you know, hip-hop is struggling. We heard about an Andrew E concert just recently that had, like, I don't know, what was it, 150,000 people? 150,000 people, oh. And we're like, oh, okay, and then we saw footage of it. We're like, wow, okay, hip-hop's very much alive. I like Andrew as a person. We can sit and talk all the time. Do I listen to his music? No, I can't relate to it. Mm-hmm. But there is a type of hip-hop that I can relate to. These are some of the smaller artists that don't necessarily get that mainstream sort of shine. So those are the different sectors. You have the very conscious, you have the very mass-based, sort of comedic, and then you have like the Glock 9s that sort of fuse the two, that are able to bring that lyrically adept nature onto a mainstream platform.
Do you think that hip-hop artists have to compromise their music, or maybe, you know, maybe the genuity of their music in order to get to be more mainstream, a little bit more than other genres?
I know every genre suffers from that to a certain extent. I just think that, I don't know, I think with hip-hop it's based so much on truth. Because especially when you're writing and you're freestyling, this is something that's coming from inside. So you can't really fake things that you don't actually live.
Well, you mentioned earlier there are some smaller artists that, you know, don't maybe get as much exposure that you're big fans of. You know, if you can make me and Quark a little bit seem like, at least seem like we're cooler, or a little bit more in the know, we'll jot down some of their names. And why do you like them?
Well, I mean, it's, you know, the difficult part about answering this question is that it's like you never want to leave anybody out. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? But I think one group that you definitely need to look at is Turbulence Productions. This fella named B-Rock, he runs this ship of producers and rappers that for a long time they've been really trying to make positive change in the industry. They had this thing called the community where they took, it was sort of this fun little project where they took different producers, DJs, and artists and sort of had them pick names out of a hat, and then they had to collaborate with each other, whoever they picked out. But there's a whole slew of artists from beatboxers like Silent to you know, people that really sort of started the poetic side of rap, like Psyche, who raps in straight Tagalog, and which I'm not very fluent in, but when he does, you understand the depth of the Filipino language, and it's just, it blows you away. Nimbus 9, definitely somebody to look out for. And then on the flip top battle side, Mooney, you know, I've seen this kid come up. I remember when Francis M was still alive, we were doing these mall tours and shows and things, and he brought this kid on stage. He goes, "Oh, you have to hear this kid. He's like scrawny little like teenager, barely hit puberty." And he got on stage. I was like, "Him, really?" Like real shy. And then he gets on the microphone and it's like, "What? Wow." And you get a slice of his life while he's on the microphone. And then now he's up to 9 million hits on YouTube. Wow. So he's sort of making a name for himself.
What's the future of hip hop?
You know, I try to reiterate this. Hip hop is not necessarily just rap music. It's really a, sort of a lifestyle and an attitude.
How far will your love for hip hop take you, and what can we expect as far as, you know, that's concerned, as well as maybe other projects that are lined up?
I think now, you know, just looking at billboards and looking at production numbers on noontime shows, the relevance and the awareness is definitely there. So hopefully with that and with the internet comes this education. I think it's really, hip hop is about educating and entertaining people, and I think I would like to be able to broaden in the options that people have in terms of what they know of hip-hop.
Well, we expect a shout out maybe here at Tease. Yeah. You know, because we aim to please.
Yeah. Oh my god, here we go.
We all about the cheese, but you guys don't
we
even
are the
know.
Bee's knees.
Ginger past 11 p.m. She's hip-hop.
No, I'm trying. No, I'm just kidding. Again, the admiration is there. I mean, I totally agree. It is beautiful poetry in my book as well. And, I look forward to hearing more stuff about you, about hip-hop, and seeing more. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you,
beautiful
guys.
Sarah Meyer.
Thank you.
We can't possibly capture everything about our guests in one interview.
So we have the lightning round, where we assault our guests with as many questions as the Wu-Tang Clan has chambers.
And they answer as fast as they can. Lightning strikes more than once. Here we go. All right, lightning strikes once. Are you ready, Sarah?
Never.
Yeah, okay, well, let me take advantage of it.
Okay.
All right, your favorite hip-hop artist.
You can't ask me that. It's like who's your favorite kid? You can't. I can't. I refuse to answer that question.
Okay. Favorite hip-hop anthem?
Dead Prez, It's Bigger Than Hip-Hop.
Rap your favorite hip-hop line.
I met this girl when I was 10 years old, and what I loved most was she had so much soul. She was old school when I was just a shorty. It's the beginning to I Used to Love Her.
Okay, favorite
that
producer?
Sucked. Favorite producer? Jay Dilla, Pete Rock.
Blood or Crips?
I'm gonna play it safe in the middle with Purple and Blue.
Your first album would be called?
Illa in Manila.
East Side or West Side?
East Side, baby. East Coast all the way.
Tupac or Biggie?
Biggie.
If you could battle anyone, it would be?
Cor Canaris.
Your DJ name is?
Sarah Sway.
When you hear an awesome beat, you?
I bump my head, close my eyes, and get lost in it.
Kanye West is a?
Genius of a douchebag.
How do you know that today was a good day?
Because we woke up.
Ever been in a gang?
No, never.
Are you down with the G-dub sound?
I am down with pretty much anything, my friend.
Do you like auto-tune?
When done properly, yes.
Do you like sampling?
Yes.
Do you like Cool in the Gang?
Yes.
Do you like me?
I love you.
Hey, there you go. All right. And you made it. There you go. Thank you very much, the beautiful Sarah Meyer.